Here's the twist. We will create website in 6 hours, no code, for free, and we will use AI tools to help us. All thanks to this video sponsor, HubSpot. HubSpot is a leading marketing software, and funny enough, I use them all the time when I was working as a marketing manager. Plus, back then, I even got a HubSpot certification through their HubSpot Academy. We will create together the structure, the design, and the content of my personal website. And the HubSpot's drag and drop website builder makes it so easy to customize your website exactly how you want it without dealing with complex coding. The huge amount of website themes plus pre-built templates eliminates countless hours perfecting design and the layout of website. Now anybody can create website and you will see it for yourself how easy it is. And to start building the website, we will first go on a HubSpot. You can check out the link in the description box below, or you can go to HubSpot webpage under software, CMS Hub, and if you scroll just a little bit below, you can see build a website with ease and you can get started for free. I already played around, so I have my business account hooked to that and I will continue with that, but I also want to show you what you would see as completely new user. First, they would ask you what industry you are in. I will go under technology and services. My role, chief business officer. Why not? And company name, we will do Gotta Go. How many people work at your company? Depends, but let's just do just me. And I don't have domain just yet. So I don't have a company website. Because HubSpot provides free hosting, so you don't have to seek another provider and link everything. Everything here is in one place. Because I'm based in EU, it recommends me EU, so I will continue with that. That's it. And you have two options. I want to build a business website and I want to build a personal website. I would go with business. And it says that it would take you around 61 minutes left to continue the whole setup. And this is what I mean by it can be very quick, I think. So I will go to the account which I created with my business email and we will take it from there. Okay, so first thing you want to do is to pick your theme of a website and you can navigate to the top right to this little house, asset marketplace, and create engaging website faster, explore themes. And you will see a lot of options, some of which are free, some cost money. We will focus only on free versions. And the one I liked was this one. Absolute. I like it. It's clean. I like the typography of it. I am going to install this. Install for free. And I'm going to set this theme as an active theme and edit theme settings. Here you go. That's it. And for the theme settings, we can navigate to the left and control colors, fonts, layout, typography, buttons, forms, headers. So I'm going to go ahead and set up global settings for this theme I picked. Okay, once you're done setting up your global settings on your theme, we will publish this theme. It's not going to be live yet, but it will apply all the settings. And we finished the task. And the awesome part is that you don't have to start from scratch. You can choose from the available templates using this theme. You can start with about page, contact page, and so on. Okay, so before we start creating pages, I went to ChatGPT to help me out with the website structure and content of that. So I told ChatGPT that it is website designer and that I want it to provide me with a structure of the pages that align with my business and objectives. And I made a list of the projects that I'm involved with. I will send that. And right away, it outlined the website structure. So the homepage, about me, projects, courses, tutorials, podcast, newsletter, blog, and contact. It breaks down each segment, telling me what elements I need to consider. And I right away see logo. Okay, when it comes to logos, I like simplicity. If this website would not be building for free, I would definitely hire logo designer or branding expert. But for the purpose of this video, I will take an inspiration from someone I really respect, which is Yulu Senyunes. We studied architecture together and his logos are clean, minimalistic, just what I like. So I'm going to try to design a prompt to use with Midjourney to get something close to that. To help me make a prompt for logo design, I'm using PromptPerfect, which allows you to upload an image and select your image model of your choice. We have DALL-E 2, Stable Diffusion, Midjourney, and I'm going to provide it with one of the logo designs that I liked. From here, I'm taking the suggested logo prompt, taking it into Midjourney and adjusting it however I like. It usually PromptPerfect provides you with words I would have never thought about. So this serves as a first step of inspiration, and then you can take and continue playing with prompts and the results that you get. So I was playing around with prompts I get from PromptPerfect, experimenting with different words, and what I settled on was this one. Black and white logo design, core elements, G and Go, and a bunch of other keywords which PromptPerfect provided me with, and I liked this one the most. I went and upscaled it, and that's what we're going to be working with. Okay, it's time to reveal logos. So you're going to click at this top level, and this is going to bring up Global Content Editor. On the left sidebar, when you see Contents, you click here, and here you can see Static Modules. Right here, we select Logo. I'm going to upload the logo that we got and change the size of it. For the purpose of this video, I think this is something that could work. Okay, so now we need Menu, and you need to start by creating one. We will create main menu now, and you just add menu items. Prompt Engineering YouTube podcast newsletter about me, contact. Okay, we will publish this. Okay, so I will definitely be playing with this, but I think for now we are done. I will move forward with actual contents of a homepage. So it's been an hour and I've been playing with designs, and I landed on something like this. Initially, I thought about different layout, but you can toggle between desktop and mobile, and I generally found out that central composition always looks better on a mobile. So this is what I got so far. I created an image, I included the brands I work with, and some call to actions. So now let's look at the sidebar, because this is where magic really happens. So on the plus sign, you have all the modules that you can play with. And what you are seeing here, that it kind of types. This is what I discovered, that you can have typing text. And I really like it, so I used it. We have social icons, which you can include as many as you want. And then call to action button. Another cool thing is that you already have designed sections. And this is amazing because you can just drag and drop them. This one, hero banner, which I used at the end for the top section of my website. And the last thing is layouts. So you can break down your layouts into one section, two, or even four. And right here, we have contents. So this is the structure of your website and how it all breaks down. I haven't gone into optimize yet and testing, because you can also run A/B tests and upload site navigation. So this is something I will do later on. I used ChatGPT to help me out, and this tagline was actually proposed by ChatGPT. I asked, I need a short tagline, and here you go. The very first one was prompt engineering practical AI. Cautiously curious, constantly creating, four C's. I really like this play of the words because that's everything what I stand for. So next thing, we are going to create individual pages. To start creating individual pages, we will navigate to marketing, website, and website pages. And right now we have only homepage. And on the right side, you can create new website page or a landing page. We will do website page. And this one I will call About Me. Once again, I can choose from available templates, and I'm going to go with About Page template. I'm going to play around. And of course, for the content of that, I'm going to use ChatGPT. Suddenly it got really dark, and right now it's raining and there is thunder. So I'm going to wrap this up and finish it tomorrow. So far, I spent 3 hours, 22 minutes on HubSpot. Half of that time was just playing around, testing all the different modules. If you really know what you want from the website, HubSpot almost had everything I could think of. And yeah, you could do it in half of that time. I also was on Midjourney playing with Logo, Canva, setting up images and some ChatGPT. So overall, realistically, I think I spent already 4.5-5 hours actively working on a website. I'm pretty happy how it is turning out. And I even set up some pages, which I'm going to just preview to you. So you need to go and check it out yourself. So on the pages so far, I got Learn Prompting, which is free resource. AI and Prompt Engineering for Everyone is Cora's course. You definitely need to check that out. I'm going to be helping students on this course, and thus my co-host is going to be representing Learn Prompting in teaching. And then there is my project, which is coming soon. I'm very excited to share this because this is huge. By the time this video is live, I am excited to announce that I will be a technical director at PolyDesign alongside Josef Press. PolyDesign is the postgraduate school in design of the Politecnico di Milano, the place with alumni like famous architect Renzo Piano. You can sign up now to enroll in an online training path designing with emerging technologies. Limited seats will be available, so check it out and use code GOTTAGO for 10% off. And also, if you are interested, I am part of SynthMinds Collective, where we provide AI services and consulting plus custom solutions. Go check that out on my website, which is going to be linked. And the last thing which is left is to do all the SEO stuff and publish. It's a new sunny day and I have 1 hour left to finish this website. At this point, I am 5 out of 8 tasks complete and it tells me that I have 26 minutes total left. Let's see if I can make it in 26 minutes. So publish and manage your web pages. That takes around 10 minutes. Let's go. Okay, so it gives us a tour. So if you want to edit pages, that's easy. You just go to edit, clone, or even more functions. Oh, you can even create multi-language variations. That's great. Okay, this is the final look that I settled on. And I highly encourage you to go check out this, my newly built website. At the end of the day, I also incorporated a form, which is already connected to HubSpot CRM system. So everything is in one place. And the brands I'm working with, including HubSpot. I'm good to go. So we are going to go and publish. Task finished. Okay. All right. 16 minutes left. We got this. Okay. Now we are going to connect custom domain, which estimates 6 minutes, which is nice. Okay. But by default, your site will be given a HubSpot domain. Got it. But you can also connect it to any domain that you own. Free security certificates included. I haven't actually bought my domain yet, so I just want to go through the whole step. Let's see. You can even buy domain inside HubSpot. All right. Okay, so it's associated with GoDaddy, which is where I buy all my domains. Okay, let's find the domain. Yeah, great. And it's in German. Okay, so gotago.com would be ideal. Yeah, it's of course not available. Gotago.d, I don't want. What if we do go? It's a bit funny, but let's check. Okay, it's available and it is for 1 cent. First year, not completely free. It's going to be costing me 1 cent, but I'm going to just for this time being roll with this. All right, so I bought the domain. So we are back at this page. So I'm going to click on connect a domain. Go.com. Okay, so this is, we are going to set up hosting. So HubSpot is working with GoDaddy, which is great. We will authorize with HubSpot. And I know it's in German, and then I tried to switch my location. The cost was higher, so I just kept it in German. But anyway, oh, it takes 60 minutes to set up. We can leave this page, and it's going to do all the setup and hosting on its own. In theory, we just run out of time, but that's working in the background. So I'm going to just leave this, and we will check again. Okay, so ta-da, we have completed everything. So to test if website is live, I have to wait 60 minutes for it setting up. So I will check in a bit. But yeah, like the whole setup was under 6 hours for sure. And just like that, I have my own personal website with all my projects. So you can check out that in a link in the description box below. This is exciting. If you need a website for your business or personal projects, it is now extremely easy to do and free with HubSpot.com. There is no excuse to not have a website today. So click the link in the description box below and create your first website for free with Drag and Drop Builder. And check out this video if you want to learn more about ChatGPT and how it works and how it can help you to create content for your website.